Our code is unstable and there ain't no test. It's churning and burning with technical debts. No test, driven development with TDD. No describing the behavior with BDD. We're coded with fear and hesitations. We got no examples, no specifications. No code to protect, the code is a rep. You know we ain't got no RSpec.
Testing with RSpec.
You're watching Testing with RSpec. I'm Greg Pollack, and this is level one, where we're going to go over an introduction to RSpec and start writing our first specifications. RSpec is one of the most popular Ruby testing frameworks, and because it is so popular, there's a huge community of developers behind it, which means there's lots of extensions and add-ons to it. It also has a less Ruby-like syntax. You might call it a domain-specific language for testing. In case you're not familiar with that term, domain-specific language, or DSL, it means that we've taken Ruby and RSpec has added additional language features on top of that to create the most efficient language for testing your code. RSpec also has very good output when you run your tests, so you can very easily see what has gone wrong in your code so you can quickly debug it. RSpec evolved out of this idea called behavior-driven development, or BDD. There's several types of testing. You've got verification testing, test-driven development, and you could say one level above that is behavior-driven development, where we really focus on describing the behavior of our application, and you'll see that RSpec and the RSpec syntax makes it really easy to do this. All right, let's jump into building our first RSpec application together. First step, obviously, we need to install the gem. So we just type gem install RSpec. That's going to install RSpec and all of its dependencies. Then inside of our project directory, we're going to call RSpec init. That's going to initialize two files for us, the spec helper and the .rspec file, which we'll go into more detail in level two. In our application, we're going to be building a zombie. Big surprise there. That zombie.rb file is going to live in our /lib directory. So let's go ahead and create the first test before we even write the zombie that describes the behavior of our zombie. In RSpec, instead of using the word test, we often substitute the word specification, but it basically means the same thing. This is why we're going to put all of our specifications in the spec directory. Our zombie lives in that lib directory, so we're going to put our first zombie test inside that lib directory. Oops, I said test. I meant specification. And so our zombie specification is going to be called zombie_spec.rb. With test unit, remember, that would have been zombie_test, but we use specifications, so we use zombie_spec.rb. Inside this file, we're going to require the spec helper, which will load the configuration for the specification. Now we need to describe how we want a zombie to behave. So we start with writing a describe block. And we say describe a zombie do, and we would then put our tests, but we don't call them tests in here, we call them examples. Here's another terminology switch. So we need to provide a lot of examples to test our zombie inside of our specification. Hope you followed. We want our zombie to be named Ash, so let's start describing that behavior. We're going to do that and declare our first example by using the it method. So we're going to say it is named Ash. We haven't fleshed out the example yet, but we're going to run this spec anyways. To do this on the command line, we simply write rspec and then the full path to the file. As you can see here, we have one pending example. Before we flesh out that example though, I'm going to show you a more typical syntax that you would use in your specifications. Instead of saying a zombie as a string at the top, instead we're going to put the name of the class that we're writing examples for. So we write describe zombie. If we run this test again, you're gonna see, uh-oh, it failed because, well, we don't have that zombie class yet. So let's go ahead and define it. So as you can see above, inside of our lib directory, we're creating our zombie.rb. All we're gonna do inside there is declare our class. Now back inside of our specification, all we need to do is require that class. Then we can rerun the specification on the command line, and here we are again, we have one pending example. Now let's write out the rest of that example by first creating a new zombie. Then we're going to write zombie name should equals Ash. And we call that an expectation. If you went through Rails testing for zombies, you might have written an assertion which looks like this, with assert equals ash zombie name. Whereas with RSpec, we would write it like this, zombie name should equal ash. And we call that not an assertion, we call that an expectation. And as you can see, it reads a lot better than those assertions. Now, if we run the test again, it properly fails. Woohoo, we have our first failing valid test. So now we can start implementing our zombie. So inside of our zombie, we're going to declare an attribute accessor, and inside of our initialize method, set its name to ash. So if we run our specification, it passes. From here, let's go ahead and write another example inside of our specification. We're going to make sure zombie has no brains when it gets instantiated. So we create our new zombie. We test that zombie brain should be less than one. There's two components here you should be aware of. More terminology. The modifier is should. Should is the modifier on our test. And the matcher in this case is that less than sign. Later on in this course, we're going to be creating our own custom matchers, which we combine with modifiers. If we run this test, it doesn't pass as we would expect. After writing the failing test, we can go back into our zombie class. We can create a new attribute accessor with brains, and on the initialize set brains equal to zero. Then when we run the spec, it passes. Let's take a look at a couple other examples of matchers that you might use inside your specifications. We can check that zombie alive should equal false. Another way we could write this is zombie alive should be false using the be matcher. We can check that zombie rotting should equal true or use the be true matcher. We can check that height should be greater than 5 or greater than equal or less than. We could also use the be matcher in there if we like the way that reads. We could say brains should be less than 1. Completely optional. Should again is the modifier, and we can switch out that should modifier for should not if you want to test that the opposite is true. In Ruby, occasionally you run into methods or you create methods that end in the question mark, which means it's a predicate method and that it returns true or false. How would we test this predicate method? We could write an example that looks like this to test that zombie hungry should equals true. However, there's a better way to write this. We could use the beTrue matcher that we just saw. We can also use a predicate matcher, which as you can see reads really well. Zombie should be hungry. So that's going to call the hungry question mark method on zombie and test it. Now if we run the spec again from the command line, it still passes. As you saw at the beginning of this level, one way to make an example pending is to simply leave off the example body. Just have the it without the do in the end, and it will be pending. There are two other ways, though, you can have pending examples, which could be useful if you're going back into a big application and you have a lot of failing tests and you want to make one pass at a time. You might want to make a bunch of them pending and implement them one at a time. You can do this in two different ways. The first is by putting an X before the it. So you just put X it, and that will cause the example to be pending. You can also simply use the pending keyword inside of your example, and that will cause the test to be pending. That's all we have for level 1. It's time to get your hands dirty with the challenges, and Olivier will see you in level 2.